He was smoking a joint, marijuana, at a gas station and caused an explosion.
Six-time Emmy-nominated Mindy Kaling was born Vera Mindy Chocolingham in June 1979 in Cambridge, Massachusetts. Her high school years were spent binging comedy shows that would influence her career, from Saturday Night Live reruns to Monty Python. She fully embraced performance while at Dartmouth College, studying playwriting, singing, acting, and even drawing the cartoons in the student newspaper. Improv with the school's Dog Day Players group followed, and aged just 19, she had a spell as a summer intern on Late Night with Conan O'Brien. She admits in her book, Why Not Me, that she treated this as a chance to watch her hero perform on stage every night, rather than a gateway to a career in TV. Something she'd joke about with O'Brien when she appeared as a guest on his show in 2006.
But I just, the doors opened and I like bolted out.
You ran away. That usually happens with me and interns. They're like, I've got to get away from this horrible, horrible man.
In 2001, she moved to Brooklyn with the intention of pursuing a comedy career. But her first TV gig was miles away from that. She worked as a production assistant on Crossing Over with John Edward, a show in which the titular psychic gave readings to audience members.
That's the area. That's the time period. This is the same school, and I have no idea what this is. Is there like a ritual, like we would all go and pee on the same wall?
The handball caught you.
In 2002, Kaling and college friend Brenda Withers debuted their comedy play Matt and Ben at the New York International Fringe Festival. A show in which fictional versions of Matt Damon and Ben Affleck, played by Withers and Kaling, accidentally happen across the script for Good Will Hunting while writing something else. The play, which Kaling describes as a cross between The X-Files and The Odd Couple, was a huge success, eventually leading to conversations with the Warner Brothers network about a TV adaptation. And so, Matt and Ben became Mindy and Brenda, a comedy about two besties surviving life in Brooklyn. It went to pilot, with Noreen DeWolf and Virginia Williams playing Mindy and Brenda, weirdly, but didn't get picked up.
Mindy, put that back.
In hindsight, it was a good thing.
Yes, hello. This is Michael Scott. I am the regional manager of Dunder Mifflin Paper Products.
In 2004, Kaling came to the attention of Greg Daniels while he was working on the US adaptation of The Office. This was Mindy's big break and a chance to show off her burgeoning talent. She was offered a staff writing job for season one of nine creatives hired for the show. Her career trajectory is linked to the success of The Office. As it found its voice in the second season, so did Kaling.
Can you make yourself cry?
No problem.
I think you should do that.
As well as writing, she played Kelly Kapoor, an exaggerated version of Kaling written especially for her.
Well, I hope you're still committed because I'm pregnant.
It's a role that expanded over the years, changing from background character to bubbly, celeb-obsessed chatterbox. Her role in the production of the show also grew, and she eventually became a director and executive producer. Kaling wrote 24 episodes in total before leaving The Office after the ninth season episode, New Guys. She did, however, return to guest star in the final episode.
I love you.
I love you too.
We're going to be together forever.
We're running off into the sunset.
I finally mastered commitment.
While this was happening, Kaling kept herself busy with other projects. In 2005, she made her big screen debut as Paul Rudd's ex-girlfriend Amy in Judd Apatow's The 40-Year-Old Virgin.
Cut it out.
Cut what out?
This going to Paris, we've been broken up for like 2 years, man. I don't want to date you anymore.
You're a whore.
And in 2007, she played Shelley in License to Wed, a romantic comedy by Ken Kwapis, which starred Robin Williams.
Damn it, Joel, what is wrong with you? You were supposed to be watching them, not tanning.
Shelly, baby, I'm on the roof.
The two would work together again in 2009 when Kaling played the role of Docent in the second Night at the Museum movie, Battle of the Smithsonian.
How about these planes dangling from the ceilings, huh? Pretty weird.
More big screen work followed in 2011 with Ivan Reitman's No Strings Attached, a rom-com starring Natalie Portman and Ashton Kutcher, in which Kaling played Dr. Shearer.
Did you think we had sex? Oh my God, we did not have sex.
Hey Adam, you left your socks in my room.
The next year she featured as Vanitha in Nicholas Stoller's The 5-Year Engagement, and she also provided the voice of Taffeta Muttonfudge in Disney's animated video game adventure, Wreck-It Ralph.
There's no way that I am racing with a glitch.
Francis, Candlehead, come on.
The same year, Kaling wrote a new pilot as part of her final season contract on The Office. It was passed over by NBC, but picked up by Fox, eventually becoming The Mindy Project. Kaling played Mindy Lahiri, an eccentric obstetrician gynecologist in a small medical practice in New York City, a role inspired by her mother.
It's important for you to know that this is not really who I am.
It was critically well received and garnered a strong fan following, running for 3 seasons on Fox before being picked up by Hulu, where it ran for another 3, finishing in 2017. As well as starring in the show, Kaling wrote many of the 117 episodes and also served as executive producer. More film work followed in 2013, when Kaling played a version of herself in Seth Rogen and Evan Goldberg's apocalyptic comedy, This Is the End. And in 2015, she played Sarah in Jonathan Levine's festive comedy, The Night Before. In 2016, Kaling played Ms. Hu in Ava DuVernay's adaptation of A Wrinkle in Time, her first Hollywood blockbuster. It didn't stop there. More movie work followed just weeks later, when she joined the star-studded cast of Ocean's 8, playing jewelry maker Amita in Gary Moss's all-female sequel to Ocean's 11.
You wanted to see the necklace and the light.
Right.
Kaling moved back to NBC with Champions, a show she co-created with Charlie Grandy. Mindy played Priya, the ex-girlfriend of lead character Vince, who finds his bachelor life upended when he has to take in the son he never knew he had.
This is your father.
What?
Hey!
Again, Kaling's role in the show was multifaceted, appearing as guest actor, a writer, and producer. Then in 2019, she wrote and starred in Nisha Ganatra's workplace comedy Late Night, in which she played Molly, a new writer hired to save the flagging career of out-of-touch TV talk show host Catherine Newbery, played by Emma Thompson.
I do a little stand-up.
Where?
If you have a problem, ask the chemist. She'll always have the solution.
The same year, she created the Four Weddings and a Funeral miniseries, based on the Richard Curtis film of the same name. She was executive producer and still found time to co-write 2 of the 10 episodes. On top of all this, Mindy Kaling is also a best-selling author. She's written 3 memoirs, Is Everyone Hanging Out With Me?, Why Not Me?, and Nothing Like I Imagined, as well as Questions I Ask When I Want to Talk About Myself, a list of 50 conversation-starting questions designed to fill any awkward silence. And that brings us to 2020 and Kaling's first production exclusively for Netflix. Never Have I Ever is a coming-of-age comedy drama based on Kaling's own childhood growing up in the Boston area. Kaling is the creator and executive producer and has also written some episodes. The show holds a 96% fresh approval rating on Rotten Tomatoes, and a second season is out now. Do you have a favourite Mindy Kaling moment? Let us know in the comments below. And remember to subscribe to Netflix UK and Ireland now for more videos about your favourite shows and movies.